So, welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not Professor Emeritus, I will be in 8 days. So. So, this is one of my last official speeches. You see, it's a text from Jutta and me, and we bet it who has to make the speech, and I lost, so I will have to give you the speech now. It's about current issues of social policy and social work in Germany. It's a very focused presentation. It's our personal view on the situation as it is now in Germany, and maybe the perspective which will be the main problem in the future of Germany. Okay, at present, social work in Germany is located in a very ambivalent position. Seen from a practical perspective, it seems to be highly appreciated. Especially the increase of professionals in the field of children and youth services, and for the inclusion of more than a million refugees within the years 2013 to 2016, has led to a situation where more or less all social workers on the job market have got a job. But seen from a professional perspective, social work is only in a few working fields been really successful in presenting and legitimizing its concrete evidence, productivity and efficiency. More and more, there is good reason to be doubtful about basic structure of the German welfare system and about the predominance of the six big welfare organizations based on either ideology or faith. First of all, data and policy. Germany is populated by approximately 82 million people in the area of social work. Actually, 258,000 persons are occupied, with 46% as part-time workers. So the figures are changing from region to region. It seems to be paradoxical. But the richer a region is, the higher is the number of social workers. With this, social work seems to be in a very strong position in so far students of social work can expect a secure professional future at this time. Since the 1990s, social work can be described as administrative practice with a steering model which is often called new public management. Since new public management, the aim of this model was to avert bureaucratic structures in local authorities in order to give more attention to market-oriented procedures. Thus, possible losses of effectiveness and efficiency within administrative and organizational processes should be avoided. Central management instruments are centralistic planning of all institutions and services, a linkage of spending with budgets, which is to avoid an increase in expenditure and a waste of money, creation of a quasi-market in order to be able to fix prices through welfare mix, and contract management, methods of controlling to manage the quality of each organization. So market principle should be used in order to manage social services. The possible effects of this strategy, cost-effective practice, are often undermined by the structure of the welfare system. Because approximately 80% of all social work services are organized and carried out by non-profit and non-governmental organizations, private and state organizations are in a clear minority. Thus, a real market structure can't come into being under the leading principle of subsidiarity. The six big welfare organizations, as you can see on the board, Caritas, Diakonie, etc., are of central political importance and using their power to streamline quality and prices nationally, and thus to hinder competition and innovation. As their specific structure comprises all levels of the organization, And imperative three includes activities from volunteers. Their political influence on the national and local policy can be estimated as very high. Consequently, the local authorities, with their rather weak management power, are confronted with politically strong and highly influential social group organizations, which are allowed to dominate the discourses on quality and efficiency. Okay. Education, second. Because of the actual positive job perspectives, the interest of young people to study social work has clearly increased. In Germany, we have 132 bachelor courses. In winter term 15-16, social work was on one of the 20 most covered courses with more than 43,000 students, amongst them 32 female students. The access to social work is very easy, as there are almost no admission criteria except a secondary school qualification. For a lot of students, this is our impression, social work is an easy way to get a university degree. In contrast to this, the possibility within a social work study are manifold. You know, the first level is a bachelor, generic courses. The second level is master course. In the master level, only a quarter of all courses have a generic perspective. Besides the different full-time courses, there are possibilities for practitioners to study a master's degree in part-time and with direct links to the working field. In the area of social work, there are almost no possibility to do a PhD course. Students who are interested have to change over to more or less suitable university programs and try to do their PhD in a combination between sociology, education, psychology, and social work. Because of the huge diversity of the different courses, a neglected interlinking between bachelor and master courses, and a lack of PhD courses, the profession of social work has not yet succeeded in establishing its own discipline at the universities. At the same time, there is no strong professional body which could help to unite professional discipline. Actually, only 6,000 social workers out of 250,000 are part of the German Professional Association of Social Workers. A short look into selected working fields. First of all, generic social work. Social workers in Germany are working in different areas, from child and youth care to health services, etc. But the problems in these areas are often that social workers can't fully demonstrate their professional knowledge because their organizations are not interested in demonstrating effectiveness. Social work in this area is seen as a basic service for all citizens without the need for accountability and victimization. For example, children and youth care, care for older people. The sector of children and youth care comprehends a huge spectrum of working as areas. Besides the services which are open to all children and young people, there is youth social work, cultural youth work, etc. And the area comprehends the huge sector of social services, whose aim is to support parents with difficulties in raising their children. Particularly in this sector of educational support, the aim nowadays is to achieve a big solution, which means that all legal claims of parents or children for educational support, for economical support, should be integrated. Thus, the legal position of each service user could be strengthened and individual service packages could be promoted to have all this personal budget. With this service, users should be able to put together the different services within a menu by themselves. But such a comprehensive form is a challenge for the traditional service deliverers because they often only supply finished products programs, special services, and don't want to adjust these services to the respective persons. So the actual debate has led to protests and resistance on the side of the welfare organization, and we will see if the government will be able to introduce the new legislation, autonomy of the client, service user orientation, which aims at supporting the personal rights of a service user, especially the right of inclusion. Another generic field is migration, maybe nowadays very interesting because of the high numbers of refugees. The working sector of migration has become very important. Due to its huge complexity, this working field is very challenging. Fundamental for working in this field is a comprehensive knowledge of the legal basis, the current administrative practices, and the legal possibilities as a precondition for a competent support within the respective information and advice and services. But because these jobs are time limited now for social workers, most of social workers in these fields are beginners who directly come from the universities with only little competence for this difficult job. At this very moment, a lot of these services are phased out without any evaluation, and a lot of young social workers at this very moment are losing their jobs. The other more interesting thing is specialized social work. In this area, social work seems to be more successful because practitioners there are usually better skilled, more experienced, and methodologically well trained. So one of the examples would be clinical social work, rehabilitation. In this working field, the willingness and capability to work in interdisciplinary teams is of prominent relevance. To work together with medical doctors, psychologists, physicians is a central task and of course a challenge. Main fields of the work is counseling, problem and solution directed, talks, the competence to mediate conflicts between family members, etc., etc. Because of a very thoroughly developed procedure to make the social diagnosis, hospital social work is now very common and has a very strong reputation in Germany. Further main methods within clinical and rehabilitation work is case engagement, of course, treatment planning, network analysis, etc., etc. Other services, for example, advisory services for addiction are broadly accepted because social workers in this area have a specific knowledge, training, and almost no concurrence by other professionals. To sum it up, the actual trend, our thesis, creeping dequalification and deprofessionalization. Different political and economical trends have led to a situation where, against the present trend, our social workers students are facing a more and more uncertain professional future. The Bologna Agreement, you know it, has brought with it the devaluation of the social German work education. The political idea that 40% of the age group should attain a bachelor degree has led to a situation in Germany where more and more unqualified and unmotivated students reach the universities. The only aim is to have a bachelor degree. The situation of 2015 and the ideology of the welcome culture has strengthened the position of volunteers and led to the impression that social work services could be organized cheaply and efficiently by experienced volunteers. With more than 1 million migrants, all social services are overloaded with clients. Young social workers now have an easy access to a job, but a lot of these jobs are part-time jobs, short-term jobs, and often unpretentious looked after jobs which could be executed by educators, trained volunteers as well. So all in all, we can find out a pretty good evaluation of the profession, which on the long run will mean for our students that they will come into precarious jobs and a situation of new poverty. There was a research in Berlin about the situation of social groups, and the outcome is that more than 50% of these people have very, very low salaries, especially women, of course, and are living in precarious conditions and can't really live with the salary of a social work position. Okay, now something which is more positive, current methodological trends. There is a debate in Germany about how can we train social workers methodologically, which should be in future the methods they are using, and there are four methods which are more prominent. The first is systemic thinking. Systemic thinking in social work means to look at the action of a client, not isolated, but always within a context of social conditions and preconditions. Thus, not only the acting of the client, but professional social work as well becomes part of the construct. The acting of the clients and the acting of the professionals are influencing each other reciprocally. And within this system of the social worker client communication, change can possibly happen by means with circular tests, question markers, etc. All in all, the aim is to help the client to be more and more able to reflect autonomously his or her own situation and problems, and to recognize new acting possibilities. Against the background of help versus non-help, the social worker tries to destroy his or her image of omnipotence. Another method within the systemic thinking is the reflection of the context. Within this perspective, the social worker can see further connections and use new contact passages. Second orientation is resource orientation. The systemic analysis doesn't only open the reflection on present communicative and social relationships, at the same time it allows to look at resources and networks within the environment of the client. Thus, social work gets the possibility to contribute as well to the improvement of the concrete life circumstances of a client. There are three central tasks in the resource orientation for social worker: respect, belief, and openness to new solutions. With special methods, for example, resource diary, the clients can see their possibilities, they can get new perspective, etc. The aim of resource-oriented social work is not only to help, but at the same time it assumes the task to transfer the accumulated knowledge about solutions and possibilities to the society. You can see both methods, they expect the social worker to create a client as a strong person, which is not usually the case in German social work practice, because usually social workers, they like the weak person, the weak services. The third thing is behavior orientation. This is very new, but more and more strategy. A research study has shown that more and more, a third of all social workers are using behavior-oriented thinking and behavior-oriented methods of practice. The basic assumption is that each behavior can be learned. You know, this, the aims are description and explication of social problems, the diagnosis, the prognosis of future problems. And methods are especially positive reinforcement and role playing. A fourth better than the last one is social space orientation. There is a big debate about this methodological trend. The aim is not only to divide or arrange the responsibilities of the organizations. Social space orientation realizes space as an event which is based on life experience. Thus, the interaction between space and the client is in the focus of the concept, and therefore interaction has to be observed and researched concerning, again, possible strengths and resources. One of the most important that it is networking. The aim is to use the social infrastructure of a given space and to combine resources and players, etc. There is a lot of talk and training around these four techniques, but nobody knows if these techniques are really applied, if software really know, are able to do these, to practice these methods, and to which extent they are efficient or valued by service users. So we come to the current problems which we have to overcome on the long run. First of all, the dissent about the role and importance of social work. In a traditional perspective, social work is based on a consensus between society, social work services, and social workers. Up to the 80s of the former century, the silent agreement was to construct social work as an alternative profession, in which the social workers tried to combine an ethical motif, an attitude, the noble deed, with a practical act based on life experience, the hiring process. The society could accept this model as long as social workers didn't earn too much money and the clients were satisfied with the different acts of helping. But with a new service culture and the uprising of managerialism, times have changed. Now clients are expecting from a social work organization, so-called best practices. The taxpayer wants to have a cost-effective practice, and social workers want to have an appropriate payment, similar to the level of teachers. So there is more and more a dissent about the role and importance of social work, especially because clients nowadays are more critically, and the media don't hesitate to blame social workers for bad quality or neglect or greed. I was telling the colleagues yesterday, there was a manager in a service organization for disabled people, and he had around 100 service users. And he made his own salary, and the level of salary was 250,000 euros. So when the public read in the newspaper that he's a social worker earning 250,000 euros, of course you can imagine outcry. And of course people will ask, what are you doing? What is the outcome? What is the profit for society? Next thing, structural deficits of the German welfare system. Social work in Germany is historical, very strongly based on two pillars. The one is poor relief, starting in the Middle Ages and being delivered by the churches. The other is voluntary work done by private associations of civil society of the late 19th century, especially executed by middle-class women. Both movements have lost their influence nowadays, even when the local authorities started to implement a new public management approach, whose aim is to strengthen citizen-oriented professional evidence-based strategies. So with the new interpretation of social work as a service offered with high quality on a quasi-market, and the client as a citizen with individual rights, the old construction of welfare is no longer valid. In this situation, the old welfare organizations, with their assumption clients should be thankful for any kind of help, these organizations tend to slow down the whole organization process. For example, they are neglecting the aim to demonstrate best practices, to strive for evidence, efficiency, or base their methods on theoretical and empirical knowledge. The result until now is there is a lack of scientific thinking and research, a lack of critical awareness, creativity, and almost no interest in permanent improvement of service. Next, difficulties concerning the cooperation with volunteers and non-professionals, particularly with the arrival of more than 1 million refugees in 2015 and 2016, it became evident that the professional system of social work is not able to react on such new challenge quickly and dynamically. So the intention of the government was to solve the arising problems by attracting thousands of volunteers. With this, it became evident that volunteers and non-professionals are an important part of the social security system, that the public is very soon of the opinion that volunteers and non-professionals could replace professionals, which means that work could be done cheaper and more effective. And volunteers and non-professionals tend to overestimate their own capabilities. A period of high motivation and readiness for action was followed after 4-6 weeks by a period of gradual loss of interest and time. These results are challenging professional social work, which has to newly reflect on the possible ways of cooperation between professional and volunteer sector and raise the question again, what is quality in social work? Our university, the Catholic University, had created a big project in favor of migrants and in favor of all these people. And there were some faculty very, very highly interested. Never ever they asked the social work faculty. Not for advice, not for support, for nothing. And I think this is up to due reasons on one side. Okay, they wanted to do something to say we Catholic students and professors are wonderful, and the other was they are there, that if we would take part, we would criticize the project. We would not only stress on empathy, on all these emotional aspects, we would have to ask more about, does it make sense? Is this respectful against a person, etc., etc. So, to sum up new perspectives, what are the perspectives, if there are a few? Our argumentation is that fundamental changes towards an improvement of methods, effectiveness, quality improvement in the system of social work in Germany are almost not possible because the university system is not open enough to offer social work as a scientific, because they have a theoretical discipline, a space where students, senior practitioners, and scientists could come into a position where theoretical thinking and practice research could be possible. And at the same time, the traditional welfare organizations are failing as a motor of change towards the modern social work, which takes clients as a person, as an autonomous person, with individual rights and dignity, and the money of taxpayers as an obligation to offer best and cost-effective services. The consequences are social work, this is our thesis, is sticking in a mental and cognitive stadium of crustification, where a liberation is only possible if the whole system would be willing to accept the so-called social work dilemma, which is that to help is a communication which informs that there is a deficit, which tells that this deficit should be overcome and make it comprehensible. that between the deficit and its removal, if there is no evident reliable, but only an uppermost contingent connection. So we can try to help, but we know that this is not possible without the activity of a client, without specific circumstances. And so we have to do something which we always have to reflect from a meta perspective. This means that torturing is no technological discipline and profession. And there is always the possibility that interventions don't reach their goal. The consequence of this is that social work has to communicate its aims, strategies, possibilities in a transparent way against the client, the public, as well as against itself, especially on three levels. On the level of organization and practices, by an open communication about possibilities and borders of social work acting, by the development of professional quality standards and transparent design of services, and by initiating and critically discussing research projects and evaluation studies, which allow the dismantling of defects and the discovery of improvements of measures. We make an analysis of different research projects from universities which were paid by the organizations. And you can say all these projects, they don't respect the rules of good research. It's all about telling the organization what we are doing is wonderful, and we as researchers and scientists agree to there's almost no critical research. Published in a journal, because the sector is not interested in an inner, let's say, in a critical debate in itself. The second, on the level of science and education, by enlarging the scientific basis within the universities, a more of empirical research and development, a close orientation towards the needs of practice, and a sustainable dialogue between science and practice. And thirdly, on a professional level, by increasing the numbers of master students and by critically discussing the reach of the bachelor level within a social work practice which should be fit for the future. Of course, we could accelerate this development if social work would be willing not only to critically reflect its strategies, but prove them against the strategy and practices of other, especially the European countries. With this, we could not only overcome our own one-sidedness and be able to recognize and remove our blind spots as well, easily discover not only best, but at the same time, evidence-proof practices. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Děkuji profesoru Arendovi. A my jsme záměrně z každé země přednášejícího pozvali také kolegy, aby případně doplnili pohled přednášejícího, případně vyjádřili jiné názory a zkušenosti. Takže máte slovo, vy, kteří jste přicestovali z Německa. A samozřejmě je prostor také pro dotazy od všech, kteří sedí v tomto auditoriu. Takže prosím, pěkně, kdo chce promluvit, protože máme na diskuzi pouze 20 minut, prosím o krátká vystoupení. Prosím, paní profesorka.
Thank you for your very interesting discussion from my perspective. Western education personalization software across Europe. And the first question is related to the PhD studies in social work or for social work in Germany. Because from my perspective, I belong to the networking of TSAS, of the International Social Work and Society Academy. And since 16 years, this network, this association, is organizing seminars for PhD students, which are followed before the plenum session of TISA is every year. And I know that there are quite a lot of German students who are joining this seminar. So, do you have PhD students or not? Because in this, I am a little confused.
Do you know who is organizing this TIS? Do you know who?
Professor Hans
Uwe, do you know from which discipline he comes?
I know that social work is...
No, social work. This is, there is no social work discipline.
But we know the identity of social work across the world. Because you read that it used to be, from the beginning, very interdisciplinary or multidisciplinary. So it means in almost each country, it has been developed by sociologists or pedagogues and so on.
In my opinion, most of these dissertation issues are not on social work. And they are on sociological aspects, political aspects, pedagogical aspects. I know Hans Uwe, Yes, in social work as such, there is no possibilities. You will have to go abroad. All you have to, as I was saying, that you have to adapt
it's the same in Poland at the moment.
Poland is the same example. And we have in the areas...
scientific identity of social work. The second question...
Okay, one more word. This was the argument of credit errors. Because now our German students, they can choose Finland. They can make a PhD in Finland in social work. They can go to Aldrich Hütil. They can do. This was the idea, because there is no real possibility. That's the case.
And you were mentioned about the actual trends in the qualification and the professionalization of social work in Germany. Of course, I know some discourses of the field, but I don't understand how to evaluate. You taught too many unexperienced social workers in responsible positions. How to evaluate if social workers are enough experienced at the position, what kind of position, because I also know that some well-educated are going into administration.
These are management positions, and you only have to go into the internet.
Yeah.
You have to read the conception of an organization, and you have to look how they use terms, if they use terms correctly. And then we'll easily see they don't know what is systemic.
Yeah.
They talk about, but they have no understanding. And so it's, you can see it, how they describe the task, which instruments they are using. And we can very easily...
Because sometimes it's very difficult to evaluate, because some young people, very good educated, are very open, and even without long experience, they can do social work.
We have regularly 100 students which go into a placement. And regularly we ask this student, please ask your supervisor, what are you doing? Which method is he using? And then the answer is usually, it's a mixture of words. It's not a concrete methodological practice.
And you mentioned about the difficulties and the collaboration between volunteers and non-professionals. So
there are a lot of people from the educational sector, pedagogs, for example, the whole
social pedagogs,
for example, but pedagogs, there is mastery in pedagogy. So that there are a lot of different, of course,
so
people.
If we can tell that social pedagogs or pedagogs are not professionals, because from
they are professionals.
Yeah.
The question is if they are skilled in. If you study pedagogy, we have a faculty for pedagogy and a faculty for social work. In the faculty of pedagogy, they have, for example, no seminars about law, about social law. There are a huge amount of social laws. They have no seminars about social management. And about methods, because they have the pedagogical language. This is the difference. But in practice, usually these organizations, they don't look, do you come from social work, do you come from pedagogy, from social, a lot of sociologists, a lot of psychologists are working in this field and are representing social work organizations. But they don't feel identified with social work. They feel as for sociologists because this is the status is higher. So this is why I'm saying we need more masters.
Yes, we, for example, in Poland we had quite a lot of masters, the professionals employed at the social institutions, about 50% more than 70 is bachelor, professional qualification, and still social work as a profession is in danger because of context of, you know, the social, economic or political situation in Poland and in Europe, So it was a question, I think.
Okay. Other comments, questions, Professor Baum? That left pretty short, yes, we have.
I tried. The question is easier.
Yeah.
Maybe your list of social work issues. I missed an approach like community work, community organizing. Maybe it's vital. Maybe you have a reason for it. But against the background of experiences and that we observe on the local level, development of social engagement and social activities, partly beside, partly beyond social work, partly very successful, partly dangerous and successful. How react social work on the against the background of community work on this developments in communities, in big cities, in villages too, like in Eastern Germany, communities are organized, youth work in communities by the Nazis. How react social work on this development? I was encouraged because you discussed the difficulties in cooperation with professionals and volunteers and are the difficulties produced by the social work, or are they produced by qualities, the people who are interested in community work or what else, but are not professional, and between social policy and social work.
Thank you. Please.
It's very simple. It's very simple. If you give a student a bachelor degree, he will maybe be able, on the long term, if he is more and more methodologically skilled, to give people advice, to coach people, whatever. But he will not be able or she to create a network of communities and of capabilities, etc. This is up to people with a master's degree. And as long as we don't have these master students, other professionals will go into this area. You will see them in community work. You will see the sociologists go to Munich. You will have 20, 30 sociologists. They are always saying, I do social work, yes, but in a real, they try to implement some community ideas in the social space. But these are not social workers, because in the German system, maybe in others as well, there is a strict separation between bachelor and master in the system of salary. Because this is lower than the other one, and you will not reach. So it makes no sense to talk too much about community work if our students are not able to manage this level. But maybe on the long run, I'm hopeful that with master and more PhD students, they will get have the same range as a sociologist or a psychologist. This is up to the system, but if we only produce the bachelor level, we will have very severe problems to make a difference between the volunteers and these bachelor social workers. I tell you one example. Eichstätt is next to Ingolstadt, it's Audi. 40,000 people working in Audi. And Audi wants his managers to do a social activity once a year. Yeah? So if you are a manager on the middle level in Audi, you will have to do something. And they come into this social organization and say, I'm a manager, of course, my Q7 is in front of the door. And now I will work with these disabled people. Tell me, give me. So we will do something. Yeah? And this is the problem. And now it's the problem with the social worker side. Stop it. You will do nothing as long as I haven't told you what. Yeah? So there is more and more, and now there is the debate about these people like me, the 65 plus people. They should do some social activities. Yeah? So there's a competition between young bachelors and old teachers, psychologists, etc. Because for the society, it's cheaper, of course, to have all these. There is a big program now to attract seniors to do. Yeah? And for young people, it's, if you are not methodologically, theoretically well skilled, you will come to trouble to work with these, to work together, to make clear who has which duties.
Thank you for the answer. And last comments or question?
Thank you very much. I appreciate your lecture, and it was clear. My question is, I don't know much about the theory, but I have practiced social work for 31 years as a practitioner. And you said something about bonuses, social
work,
bonus money, about 350,000 euros. Fair, why not social workers should earn that? Managers in England, or people having bonuses when they retire, millions. My question is, why is it hospital social workers in Germany, medical social workers, haven't got the importance. Thank you.
For me, it's this special example of hospital service. It's the concurrence and the competition with the other professions. If you work in a multidisciplinary team, you will have to bring in your perspective. And if you are not able to bring in your perspective, you will be someone who only have to do the lower services. So these hospital socials, they tried to create something like a professional identity, and we could say research and methods in order to play a role in this area. And but in other areas, there is almost no competition, and there is always, you could say, it's a black box. If someone goes into a family, you don't know if the child is abused or not. There is a communication, there is something. Nobody knows what is going on. If there is no documentation, social workers don't like documentation. But what is going on in this hour? How someone is creating a social diagnosis, etc., etc. So there is too much hidden, and it's up on the long run to the social work academics to offer tools and ticking boxes, whatever, to offer something to bring more transparency into these areas. We have the neglect of children in homes. We have child abuse. So there are lots of things which we now that now have to see, but the public is almost not interested. We have hundreds of thousands of children abused in homes. Homes from the church, homes from the other organizations. All black boxes. There was no social work to say, here is a problem. Because there is no social work professional body. In other countries, social work would be obliged to say, here is something going on. In Germany, there is always this, it's hidden, and so we need more and more a strong profession who is tackling these problems. Otherwise, it will go on, and we will not respect the autonomy of children and of our clients.
Thank you very much, Peter. Prosím, ta debata byla velmi důležitá podle mě proto, že poukázala na to nebezpečí, které pro sociální práci přinesl bolestný proces. Ten vývoj v evropských zemích je následující. Existují evropské země, ve kterých sociální pracovník může pracovat pouze tehdy jako profesionální sociální pracovník, pokud má magisterský diplom studií. Finland je zlatým základem. A Slovensko je další příklad. V Německu, když má možnost sledovat ten vývoj od počátku 90. let, tak to snížení počtu roku studia vede k tomu, o čem mluvil profesor Hrad. A vede také ke snížení autority sociální práce, samozřejmě. Takže to je věc k diskuzi, které model je lepší, jestli ten finsko-slovenský, nebo jestli ten, který existuje u nás. Ale velké nebezpečí je po mém soudu v tom, o čem mluvil profesor Hrad, to je deprofesionalizace sociální práce. Ten tlak na deprofesionalizaci sledují v Evropě v průběhu té diskuze, o kterou mohu nazvat Back to the Roots. S tím začali v 90. letech někteří kolegové zpět ke kořenu a mysleli tím, profesionální sociální práce by měla být možná, protože v 19. století ji dělali ty dámy z dobře situovaných rodin a to byla ta správná sociální práce. Takže prosím pěkně, to jsou dvě tendence, o kterých bychom měli diskutovat i odpoledne,